but you can hurt me. For today's video, I wanted to do a DIY with you guys because it has been far too long since we have entered into the realm of DIYs. Honestly, I kind of stopped doing DIYs because they were more like TIYs where I was trying it for the first time while filming it for the first time. And I feel like that's gonna be like the ongoing joke. Like anytime I do DIYs from here on out, this is just a disclaimer. This is me trying it at the same time as I'm filming it. For the sake of it being searchable on YouTube, we'll call them DIYs, but for the sake of, you know, just fam to fam, they're really just DIY. So with summer coming up, and also just the fact that a lot of you guys have been requesting on my Instagram and such, like where I get my band tees and all of that fun stuff, I thought it would be a really fun DIY to do like 10 different ways to cut sweaters and t-shirts for the spring and summertime. They're going to be very Tumblr-esque and fun and just easy to do and so, so cute. So if you guys want to know how to cut 10 different shirts and sweaters for the summertime, then just keep watching. So for this first t-shirt, I actually picked this up from Walmart, if I'm being honest with you guys. It was like $9, and I'm just using this fabric pen to kind of mark out where I want to crop it. And then right before you kind of cut out the very edge, you just clip downwards, and then you kind of have this like strip, and then you're just going to want to curve it so that it's easier to tie. And then when you open the t-shirt back up, cut it straight down the middle, and honestly, that's all there is to it. It's super easy. You can do this with like any type of logo tee, and it just kind of gives it a cute crop, but with the tie off, and yeah, I don't know. $9, can't go wrong, am I right? But you can hurt me. So this next sweater might be my favorite one from this whole DIY. I grabbed one of these crew necks from Brandy Melville, and then I just marked off where I wanted to crop it and cut off the bottom. And then I just used this like label as a marker as to where I wanted to cut the slits down the sleeve. So you could use a ruler for this or literally just anything, but I just wanted to make sure both sides were even. And then using fabric scissors, I cut the slits and then used the eraser on the fabric marker to get rid of the purple lines. And then I just did the exact same thing to the other side. And I bought this little Harvey Davidson label from Brandy Melville too. And because this is a no-sew tutorial, I literally just used some fabric glue to glue it into place, and this is like a okay to wash it type of glue, so it'll stay on. When the train goes away, I'm gonna lose my cool like I'm losing the whisper. Next one is again super easy. I went ahead and cut off the label, and then using the fabric marker marked out a deep V, and then you can make this as deep as you like, and then used the fabric scissors to cut it off and then cut around the collar at the top. And then I just used the eraser to erase the markings and used that okay to wash it glue to roll up the sleeves and glue them into place, kind of like sewing them into place, but just so much easier. And that's it. Like honestly, this one was so easy. You could crop it too, but it's just one of those cute little things you could do to logo tees to make it just a little bit more funky. And if you guys watched my playlist vlog, you'll know I picked up this Slytherin sweater and I really wanted to do something fun with it. So obviously pretty standard. If you guys just want to crop a sweater, I'm sure you guys know how to, but I just made markings on both sides and cropped it. But then I thought, you know what, let's spice it up just a little bit more. So then I went ahead and cut a slip up the middle and then tied it off and make sure to double knot it into place. And that's all you have to do. And it makes this kind of like, I don't know why it reminds me of Kelly from Saved by the Bell, but I don't know. I just like the style of this and it just adds a little bit more extra. And then as for this next t-shirt, I'm gonna show you guys how to do the lace up detailing. So again, fabric marker, cutting up the slit, kind of like we did for the other t-shirt, only this time I'm using the fabric marker to mark where I want the lace to be, and then using an X-Acto knife to just puncture little holes. Be very, very careful because obviously it's super sharp. And then I just used some shoelaces, but you guys could buy string, whatever it is you want, and then laced up the tee and knotted it off. And I did this to two different t-shirts so you guys could get a vibe for white and a black one. So yeah, again, so freaking easy and so like no sew, no nothing, just yeah.
So
So for this next sweater, I literally picked this up from H&M. I think it was like $15. And I'm just using the fabric marker to cut out little slits in the sleeve to kind of have like peekaboo shoulders and arms. And then using fabric scissors, I'm going ahead and cutting that right down on each side. So, so easy to do. And it just adds a little bit extra to that, you know, sleeveless sweater look, and also really good for the summer. And then again, I just wanted to add a little bit more to it. So I went down the middle and cut up the sides. And I find that this is a really easy thing to do to your sweaters if you want them to be just a little bit more, like, I find them more appealing to wear, like they're more flattering. So yeah, that's all I did to this sweater, and it just added so much more to such a basic sweater. I've recently been obsessed with the look of like ratty logo tees. So I took this Led Zeppelin shirt and I just cut off the collar on the top and cropped it down the bottom. And you could leave it just like this, but I wanted to add more to it, make it a little bit more like punk rock, you know what I mean? So I took the X-Acto knife and I'm literally just cutting holes and like stretching it out, and just, again, be super careful because it is really sharp, but just keep doing this until it's about as distressed as you want it to look. And I find that this looks really, really cute with like leggings or like ripped up jeans. It just gives you that like, I've got holes all over my shirt and in my heart kind of look. Easiest DIYs you could do to a sweater is cut out slits in the elbows. I don't know why this is a trend, but I just find it super cute. Grandparents and parents are probably like, why are there slits in your elbows? But because style, okay? So easy to do, and it just adds a little extra to your sweater, you know? And then next, I'm gonna show you guys how I cut up this Justin Bieber shirt, because we cannot do a DIY without some Justin Bieber in it. I mean, we can, but I'm just taking some fabric marker and marking off the V in the front like we did before, but then I'm also cutting out the shoulders too, just to add a little extra. And then I'm gonna use the X-Acto knife again to create that kind of ripped up and hole distressed shirt. So I'm doing that all over, just making sure to be careful not to cut any holes like where your lady parts are, because that just wouldn't do us any good at all. And because this is a longer one, I cut up a slit in the middle too, so that I could tie it off, so you can tighten it like a dress or roll it up into a t-shirt. So you'll see what I did here. I just knotted it off, and then once you put it on, you can tighten it and adjust the size or like the length of it, or you can tie it tight and roll it up into a t-shirt. Last sweater, if you guys remember this Maximum COZE, I'll leave a link to it down below, but it was part of my merch come Christmas time. And I'm just taking the top and cutting off the shoulders again. And then at the bottom, instead of just doing a normal crop, I kind of wanted to do like an angled crop and just see how that worked out. And I ended up loving it. So I took the scissors and just cut up on an angle. And there you have it. Honestly, just two cuts, and it just completely changed the sweater. You can wear it off the shoulder, off both shoulders. And I don't know, it's just really cute and perfect for lounging around the house. So that is it for my 10 easy DIY no-sew tops for the spring and summer. Let me know which one was your favorite down below, and if you guys decide to try any of them out, tweet and Instagram them at me, because I would love, love, love to see them. And if you guys want more DIYs or TIYs, then just let me know. And other than that, I will see you guys all in my next video. Bye, guys. But I don't wanna grow up, we can stay forever young. Living on my sofa, drinking rum and cola underneath the rising sun.